We were absolutely thrilled when we received the results from Abich Laboratories in Italy after they had tested our products. So we put it through a really extensive testing regime. We had wrinkles, we had elastin, we put it through mutagenicity, that is a hard word to say, and toxicity and Ames testing, so we could make sure that everything was safe and that everything worked to the best of its capability. So they put 100 volunteers and they used an in vivo 3D scanner to measure the topography of the skin, and they also used a cutometer, which is a digital probe which can measure the cutaneous mechanical wrinkles there. So all of those numbers and all of that body of data were amazing, but there were still such simple questions that I couldn't answer, like how long does a bottle of One Truth last? So I actually, on top of that whole body of research, did my own clinical trials with real people here in New Zealand so that they could ask me questions, share feedback, and talk to me. And actually a lot of our before and after shots come from that very first trial that we did. And if any of you have already had a look at the video testimonies from the people that partook in that trial with me, you'll notice that they actually never say the words One Truth 818 Serum, because it hadn't even been named yet. That's the what early days that it was. But we were so surprised from the results of our trial in terms of things like skin sensitivity and pigmentation. So we said, yeah, look, we know that it's already scientifically proven that re-lengthening telomeres will reverse the age of your skin. So we're expecting wrinkles to disappear. But the questions I was having was, what about my rosacea? What about my broken capillaries? What about the pigmentation I've got from pregnancy? And my real answer to these women was, I don't know. The broken capillary could be environmental, or it could be the product that you're using, or it could be damage you've done to your skin. The pigmentation from hormones, if you hadn't got knocked up and had that kid, you wouldn't have had that. So is it age-related? Isn't it? So we were all really impressed to find out that topical telomerase activation decreases sensitivity in the skin. Our volunteers had pigmentation. Everyone's pigmentation diminished. Some of their pigmentation even vanished. And we ran the trial. So the Abich Laboratory Labs, it was a 30-day trial. Here back home, I did a 2-month trial so that we could really find out what our product was doing to people. So for people to be coming back to me and going into Visia machines and having their wrinkles and their sensitivity and things measured right before my eyes, to see capillaries rebuilding, restructuring, and withdrawing back from the skin, and redness completely diminishing, to see pigmentation vanishing, we were really, really impressed and realized that it kind of makes sense. Because if you make your skin a younger skin, it starts to behave like a younger skin. So you don't have melanocytes that suddenly go haywire and cause this pigmentation, because the turgor and the strength of your skin is that of a younger skin again. Your capillaries probably aren't going to bust, because let's face it, our kids run around outside in the cold and then come inside to the heat and knock their faces on the concrete grounds. They don't get broken capillaries. A younger skin handles it and older skin doesn't. So the easiest way for me to describe the action of inducing telomerase topically is that your skin reverses its age. So it acts like a younger skin. So we can kind of explain, you know, vitamin C will synthesize collagen in your skin. That's what it does. Vitamin A, you'll get exfoliation, the cells will line up, it'll regulate it. Well, what does TAM818 do? What does topical telomerase activation do? Well, it reverses the cellular age of your skin, so your skin behaves like a younger skin. And our independent testing proved that. And the testing that we did ourselves, once again over and above that, did that. So before we even went to market, we had 140 volunteers trying our product. We had one problem with that, and it sounds like a funny problem when you hear me say it, is that not one person had a reaction to it. So I actually had to take a product to market not knowing if anyone had a reaction, what it would be, because nobody had a reaction to it. Nice problem to have, huh? So it was really interesting, because sensitive skins loved it. Obviously, older skins Loved it. And I will tell you, because it is quite funny, the only issue that we had come back to us was from the beauty therapists themselves, who said, I'm actually getting a couple of breakouts. And when I said, well, what kind of skin have you got? They actually, everyone who had a little breakout had really oily skin. And I had to say to them, look, you know, when you use One Truth 818, it feels like velvet. It just sinks straight into your skin. It's easy to forget what a really rich formula it is. It's actually got a really high oil content in there, but people love it so much that they start lathering it all over their faces. And so it wasn't, I didn't realize how much I had to say that to people, because nobody had had a reaction until we actually went to market. And now it's just common practice for us to say, if you've got a really oily skin, just use this on your eye area or your neck area. Don't lather it all over your face like I know that you want to. But it was very funny taking a product to market without having any reactions against it, and kind of cool too.